Hi there. I'm Andrea Scheibel, a percussionist and Society for New Music board member, and I'm going to be your host for today's program. Welcome and thank you for joining us. We'll open today's program with a performance by New Hartford Rising Star violinist Rosé Head performing Mozart, the first movement, Allegro, of his third violin concerto written when Mozart was 19, just a few years older than Rosé. Mozart wrote his concerto for one of his colleagues in the orchestra, but he was also a fine violinist and pianist and performed the concerto himself at another occasion. Greg Welcher is also a performer and composer, in his case, a pianist and composer. He is a native of Baldwinsville, New York, just north of Syracuse. Greg Welcher was already a prize-winning pianist when he participated in Society for New Music's Young Composer's Corner back when he was 12 or 13. He is now in graduate school at Rutgers University in composition, and is also making good use of his piano skills. His piece, Isolation, is a reflection of the experience we've all shared this past year.
Thank you.
Greg Shepherd is a Syracuse native who grew up in the projects, went on to Syracuse University, and then to New York City. He's had an international singing career, is now head of Opera Ebony, and in charge of outreach for Syracuse Opera. Just last February, he sang a recital here at Utica College for Black History Month with Utica pianist par excellence, Sar Shalom Strong, the pianist we'll hear today. The first three songs he's going to sing are by Florence Price, Coleridge Taylor Perkinson, and Charles Lloyd Jr. You're about to hear music by composers who may not have been in most history books, but that's beginning to change. Florence Price was a native of Little Rock, Arkansas, but settled in Chicago and taught there and at the New England Conservatory. A composer, pianist, organist, and music teacher, Price is noted for being the first African-American woman to be recognized as a symphonic composer and the first to have a composition played by a major orchestra, in this case, the Chicago Symphony. Keep in mind that she was one of the first composition teachers Margaret Bond studied with. We'll hear a couple of her songs as well at the end of the program. Coleridge Taylor Perkinson was born in New York City and studied at the Manhattan School of Music. He was at ease in jazz, dance, pop, film, television, and classical music. Served as music director of the Alvin Ailey Ballet, Symphony of the New World, and other distinguished musical groups. Coleridge Taylor Perkinson was named after Afro-British composer Samuel Coleridge Taylor. Charles Lloyd Jr. was born in Toledo, Ohio, and earned his bachelor's degree in music education from Norfolk State University in Virginia, and a master of music degree from the University of Michigan in piano performance. Early in his career, he toured Europe as a pianist accompanist and has served on the faculty of Southern University in Baton Rouge, Louisiana for many years.
Here a little child I stand, giving up my either hand. Cold as paddocks though they be, here I lift them up to thee, for a benison to fall on our meat and on us to bear, which cross. not know.
Are scenes from the Society for New Music commissioned opera about Libba Cotton, who grew up in the segregated South. She became famous for one of the first songs she wrote, Freight Train, which was picked up and toured by pop rock groups here in the US and Britain. However, because it wasn't copyrighted, she never earned anything for it. She was married at 14 and moved around between DC and New York City, had a daughter, and was divorced. She was working in a department store in Washington, D.C. when a little girl became separated from her mother. Libba found that the mother of the little girl, who happened to be Ruth Crawford Seeger, a famous composer and ethnomusicologist. Mrs. Seeger was very grateful to Libba and offered her a job as a domestic. Libba accepted. Years later, she picked up a guitar in the Seeger household and began playing. This musical family was astonished with what they heard. They helped her build a career. After all, folk singing was what they were famous for. But how did she end up in Syracuse? Because her grandson was a minister at a church there. Libba was making money performing and decided houses were reasonable in Syracuse. So she bought a house for herself and her daughter to be near her grandkids. Over her 20 years in upstate New York, she entertained students at the Martin Luther King School, where there is a wall of her memorabilia. She won a Grammy at age 93, and has a park named after her in Syracuse, complete with a statue.
Frances McMillan Parks had a dream. She, like Libba Cotton, grew up in the segregated South. As an African-American woman, teacher, and storyteller, Frances related to Libba. Joining Frances in her dream were Sandra Hurd and Joel Potash, who donated the seed money to get the Libba Project underway. Motivated Libba, a domestic at age 9, songwriter at 11, and Grammy winner at 92. What was Libba's connection with the Seeger family? Why did Libba move to Syracuse? What did Libba have that inspired members of the Grateful Dead to visit her in Syracuse? Just as Pete Seeger, Bob Dylan, Mike Seeger, Taj Mahal, Peter, Paul, and Mary all were performing her songs. Now it's time to meet the librettist and composer.
Thank you.
years uncast in bronze.
Chug, 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 chug
me far when I'm home.
And so she's working as a woman, she's working in a department store, and a little white girl gets lost, you know, and that little white girl's mother is, you know, is Peggy is Seeger, and great, you know, folk singing and interested family, and they sort of quote unquote discover her, but not until they bring her into their house as a domestic. And then as the story goes, and I understand it, they kind of hear someone playing guitar. And so it's many decades later that she picks up that guitar again. Now she's in her 60s. Mm. And she picks up that guitar, and she happens to be in the home of people who recognize, appreciate, and are conservators in some level of this music, right? And suddenly out of their kitchen, right, with the smell of the soup and the steak, is this music that's coming. And they're like, what on earth? And so they take her on tour, and you know, and then she becomes a legend in folk music. But the timing was right too, because of course there were, you know, we had a lot of white folks doing folk music. We had a lot of, you know, something very, I won't quite call it appropriation, because it wasn't that. It was really honorific, I believe. But then there was a movement toward more authenticity, and what could possibly be more authentic than Libba Cotton, who taught herself to play, a Black woman coming out of the South, playing this music that's also, that is folk, but isn't, that it holds gospel, as Mark was talking about, it holds the blues as well, right? So she was a treasure, because, you know, like this living sort of artifact and proof, right? And so, and in some ways, she legitimizes the Seegers and the work that they're doing, mm-hmm. because they bring her in, right? And, you know, yes to all that, but the piece is really about, you know, how is it that there's a statue in Syracuse, New York to this woman? And what, you know, what do we learn about her as we situate her in a, again, as I said, a liminal space as she moves toward home, both metaphysically and nostalgically.
Thank you. And now let's hear from our singers.
Libba in our kitchen.
Washing plates and pans.
Libba in our kitchen.
Making busy hands.
Libba in our kitchen.
I found an old guitar. Fingers, remember. Remember, heart. Come on now, left hand. You used to know this part. These are the old songs. This here's tune brand new. This hymn's got my take on it. This song's just for you.
Play like that.
Nobody except you.
Libba, who taught you to play like that?
Nobody did teach me. Nobody did. Just me.
A simple tune.
Repeats itself.
Only a few modest variations.
Her left hand, effortless.
It's superb. It's genius.
Well, never mind those dishes. And never mind those chores. You can't be our little secret, Libba.
That's folk music from the source.
So never mind those dishes. Just never mind those chores.
What a find you are, Libba.
Come away, Libba.
You can't be our little secret, Libba.
Come away, Libba.
So come away now, Libba. We're taking you on tour.
Come away, Libba.
We're taking you on tour.
Criminal, yes. That music's itinerant,
yes.
That's worthy, swarming music they're playing with.
Preach.
Why you think they call it the moon?
Preach.
A dozen words in my heart.
Sing the gospel with your heart, little sister.
Praise Jesus with your song.
It was God, give me my songs.
Was God give you your voice? Was the devil put that word of music in your left hand?
Sin, come away from the guitar, little heart.
Put the devil music on.
Down, kneeling on behind, sister. Put the devil music
down.
Say, come away now, little from that guitar.
Next, we'll hear Greg Shepherd and Sarah Strong perform a couple of songs by Leslie Adams. Born in Cleveland, Ohio, he earned a Bachelor of Music Education from Oberlin College, a Master of Music from California State University, Long Beach, and a PhD in Music from Ohio State University. He taught as a faculty member at the University of Kansas, but there were many years when he lived off accompanying ballet classes and serving as a choral conductor, all while writing a wide range of music. His works have been performed by the Buffalo, Indianapolis, and Cleveland Symphonies, among others.
That all my foes might grapple. above thy body, absorb thy body.
American composers you've already heard, Dr. Mike Woods is as at home in jazz as he is with classical and often fuses those idioms together in his music. Doc is a double bassist as well as a composer and earned his doctorate at University of Oklahoma. He has served on the Hamilton College faculty for many years, in addition to heading up his own jazz combos. Doc will give some background on the sneak preview of his piece, which will be premiered with dance on February 26th in Syracuse as a live streamed event. Doc fortunately had the music completed before he became ill with COVID, which put him in the hospital. He's now feeling much better and strong enough to introduce himself and his music to you.
Greetings. My name is Dr. Michael Woods, and I'm one of the composers that's having one of my selections played on the program sponsored by the Syracuse New Music Society. I'm very grateful to have this opportunity. The name of my selection is called An Expensive Truth. And what it means is that all truth is expensive because it has to be lived out and acted out for it to actually become truth. The idea was to write a piece of chamber music that combined jazz influences and classical influences. Only small portions of the piece are improvised until it gets about three quarters of the way through the piece. And then there's a whole section that is aleatoric and based on chance elements and improvisation. And the musicians are expected at that point to have some fun with the music and take it to some strange and wonderful places. There are small solos written for the violin, cello, and soprano sax, but the solos are written out exactly like chamber music. I sure hope that you enjoy this piece, and I'm very honored to have it performed and very thankful for the New Music Society honoring me with this opportunity. Thank you very much.
program with music by two more African-American composers, perhaps somewhat more famous in their lifetimes than the earlier composers we've heard. Margaret Bonds started music lessons with her mother at age 4. She was a very accomplished pianist and composer who earned her degree at Northwestern University at a time when she, as a Black woman, couldn't live in a dorm there. She met poet Langston Hughes in 1936, and they became great friends, which is why she set many of his poems to music. In 1964, Bonds wrote Montgomery Variations for Orchestra, a set of 7 programmatic variations on the spiritual, I Want Jesus to Walk with Me. Bonds penned a program for the work, which explains that it's centered on Southern Blacks' decision to no longer accept the segregationist policies of the Jim Crow South, focusing on the Montgomery bus boycotts and the 1963 bombing of the 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham. In 1964, she shared it with Ned Roram, a close friend and former student. She eventually dedicated the work to Martin Luther King Jr. 2 years later, she moved to Los Angeles, teaching music at the Los Angeles Inner City Institute and the Inner City Cultural Center. Zubin Mehta and the Los Angeles Philharmonic premiered her Credo for chorus and orchestra in 1972. Unfortunately, Bonds died unexpectedly a few months later, shortly after her 59th birthday. Billy Taylor, an American jazz pianist, composer, broadcaster, and educator, was the Robert L. Jones Distinguished Professor of Music at East Carolina University in Greenville. In 1994, he was the Artistic Director for Jazz at the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts in Washington, D.C.
Talk about you way in the middle of the air. in the middle of the air, it's equal sort of wheel. Away in the middle of the air, and the big will run by faith, and the little will run by the grace of God. Wheel in a wheel, way in the middle of the air. Watch out, my sister, how you walk on the cross. Way in the middle of the air, your foot might slip and so be lost. Way in the middle of the air, Ezekiel saw the wheel turning way up in the middle of the air. Ezekiel saw the wheel way in the middle of the air, and the big wheel run by faith, and the little wheel run by the grace of God. Wheel in a wheel, way in the middle of the air. You say the Lord has set you free, way in the middle of the air. Why don't you let your neighbor be? Oh, way in the middle of the air, Ezekiel saw the wheel turning way up in the middle of the air.
Again for joining us. We're very much looking forward to the day when we can all be together again and playing music for you in person. Until then, check out our live stream performance on Friday, February 26th, featuring the premiere of An Expensive Truth composed by Doc Woods. Take care and stay safe.